welcome along to the 2016 Ford Focus RS on New Zealand roads, finally. There's been a huge amount of hype around this car, and I've bought right into it. I've spent a lot of time in a vortex of YouTube videos and articles about this car.
Overseas
automotive journalists. So I'm very excited to have an opportunity to drive one on our roads. First thoughts on the car? Well, it's good. It's a really cool thing to look at, and it's a nice place to be inside. So I'll start there. The fixtures, materials in here feel good. It feels like they've used the good stuff. Because it's built in Germany, it feels German, and it probably needs to, because this car is now up against the likes of the Mercedes-AMG A45, the Audi RS3, and the Volkswagen Golf R. That's because this is the first Ford Focus RS with a four-wheel drive system. So, where it was a trend of WRXs and Evos
scrapping it out,
the German companies have now taken that formula and perfected it, turned it into these amazing hot hatches that we've got on the road, different from the original hot hatches, the 205 GTIs, the Mark 1 GTIs. These cars are now proper hyper hatches, I've heard it said, and I'd have to agree. This Ford Focus, does it reset the bar? I don't know, those cars are very good. The A45 and RS3 in particular have more power and are more expensive, so this is a slightly different proposition again. This is in line with the new STI and the Volkswagen Golf R, and I'd say, yeah, they're all pretty much on par. WRX has probably gone a bit soft over time, and the Golf R, well, they fell out of failure. Emission scandals. Do people driving Golf R's really care? Probably not. The one benefit they do have in my eyes is multiple box options. So they've got the DSG and the manual box. This RS only comes with the 6-speed manual, which in a lot of people's eyes is going to be a good thing. But for people who are considering these vehicles for day-to-day commuters, it probably takes them out of contention. So who are they for then? Well, I'd suggest we're going to see a lot of these Focus RS's in garages alongside 911s, alongside Ferrari 488s, alongside some really, really metal, because these are a great mini version of these. You know, again, I've heard these compared to Nissan GT-Rs, small Nissan GT-Rs. Obviously, this manual box makes all the difference. I just stopped and had a chat to a gentleman in a new GT-R with his Clio RS daily driver tailing him on some pretty cool roads. We'll have a look at that video a bit later on. But yeah, look, I think it's going to be for guys who and girls who want something small, cool, something they can throw around and take to the supermarket and to the track. So yeah, I think it'll find favour with Kiwis. The one issue I do see is the lack of stock. Ford New Zealand has already sold out of Focus RS's. The allocation for 2016 is gone, and I understand 2017 is either gone or very close to being gone. So to get your hands on one of these cars, you're going to have to wait. But that does bring up another interesting issue for buyers. Will depreciation be that of a normal car? If you have a look at the previous generation Focus RS, there's only ever two or three available in the country, and prices have held up pretty well. They still sit around 50 to 55 grand for a good example, with around 30-40,000 k's in them. You'd have to say that this will probably do the same thing. So at a list price of 70 grand plus the extras, if it was my money, I'd be getting these shell seats, and I'd be getting the 19-inch forged alloy wheels. It puts it close enough to 75 grand on the original list price. I have heard rumours that list price will be going up, as it would, supply and demand. But 75 grand, hey, if it comes down to 55 in 3, 4, 5 years, that's not bad depreciation compared to, say, for 75 grand, a Hyundai Santa Fe or a Mitsubishi Pajero or something else that's really boring. Here comes an old Model T, taking a lot. We should stop and have a chat to him. So the more we drive this car, the more we realise how capable it is. You know, we're in normal driving mode at the moment. It's very comfortable. It does everything you want it to do. These shell seats and I'll go into it later on when we're probably driving the car, they're the most supportive I've sat in. They're really nice, and they don't take up all the rear passenger leg room either. You've actually got enough room in the back for a child's car seat while the seats are, you know, pretty close to the back. One gripe I do have, me and a couple of the other guys from the office jumped in and put the seats down, but they don't go as low as you'd like them to. My line of vision is probably just on the bottom of the sun visor. I'd like to be a little bit lower if I could, but hey, it's not a biggie. Another thing I have noticed is the windscreen wipers. While everything is fantastic, the wipers are cheap and skinny. In Kiwi inclement weather, you want wipers that are thick and heavy and don't scuttle along the windscreen. So if I was going to have a gripe, that'd be it. And maybe if Mr. Ford could offer an automatic gearbox, I'd be very happy as well. So yeah, otherwise a really cool car.